Welcome back, Vinyl Community, to a video I had hoped I would not have to make, but alas, I do, and it is right and proper to pay respects and tribute to one of the greatest voices Jamaica has ever produced. The voice you're hearing right now, that of Frederick Toots Hibbert. Just like that, has left this world at 77 years of age on September 11th, 2020. Complications from the COVID-19 virus. After being placed in a medically induced coma for several days and weeks. We had hoped he would pull through, but alas, it was not to be. Title track of his 1980 LP, Just Like That. Voice of Frederick Toots Hibbert of Toots and the Maytals. Deeply soulful, based on his upbringing in the church, singing gospel, as the son of Seventh-day Adventist ministers. Was born in Maypen in the parish of Clarendon, Jamaica. Maypen would give its name to his group, the Maytals, which he formed in the early 1960s after moving to Trenchtown following the death of his parents. Trenchtown, Jamaica. A musical hotbed of up-and-coming singers like Bob Marley and the Wailers and many others. Toots Hibbert, one of them. It was in Trenchtown that Toots Hibbert linked up with Jerry Mathias and Raleigh Gordon to form the Maytals. They began recording for Studio One Records. Immediately striking with hit singles. Toots Hibbert was all of 19 when their debut album, Presenting the Maytals, was released around 1963-ish, I believe, early 1960s. I don't have that one. Presenting the Maytals, also known as Never Grow Old, the original Maytals right there from the book, the album cover art of Studio One Records. The song Never Grow Old also gave its name to Studio One discography and rhythm directory. Never Grow Old, Studio One Records Guide. Following their time at Studio One, where they had many hit singles, Toots and the Maytals branched out. Some of their songs in the early days were credited to the Vikings, like this one, which appeared on a very early Island Records label. X Sound System copy from the markings, song called Hallelujah, again underscoring the church background of Toots Hibbert. More than perhaps any other singer in Jamaican music, he made clear the link between American soul music and especially gospel of the church, and the links between that side of Jamaican music and American music. Toots Hibbert, and that immediately recognizable lead vocal of his, credited to the Vikings, very early Island Records label. Island Records founded by Chris Blackwell, who would have a long-standing relationship with Toots Hibbert, produced many of his albums in the 1970s. In 1966, Toots Hibbert won the very first Jamaica Festival song competition with the Maytals' song Bam Bam. He would go on to win it again in 1969 and in 1972, would compete in it many other years as well. But in 1966, he was jailed for 18 months for marijuana possession, which he claims he was innocent of. He claimed he was set up by other parties, wanted to sideline him from the music business, did 18-month sentence. This inspired one of his signature songs, 5446, That's My Number, which became a absolute classic upon his release and a signature of his performances ever afterward. Following this, the Maytals would link up with various other producers that they would work for, Prince Buster, Byron Lee. They would record for Leslie Kong's Beverly's label some of their most successful singles. Leslie Kong and Beverly's, It Must Be True Love, right here. The Maytals, still credited to the Maytals. Many of their songs would cross over to the emerging skinhead crossover market in the UK, where songs like Pomps and Pride, Monkey Man, Sweet and Dandy would be very, very successful on the UK market, finding favor with the white skinhead audience, crossing way beyond traditional Jamaican audiences, and raising the profile of the Maytals to an even higher degree, firing out hit singles as the early ska era gives way to rock steady and then to early reggae. In fact, in 1968, the Maytals song Do the Reggae, spelled R-E-G-G-A-Y, was fairly universally considered the first song to ever use the word reggae in a song title. Not necessarily the first song with the reggae beat, but the first song to name check it on record, what was going on, the new beat of the music, that would it would be known as Forever After, the Maytals song, Do the Reggae. Many other classics would follow. In the early 1970s, a film called The Harder They Come broke Jamaican music to a much larger audience than ever before. It starred Jimmy Cliff, and in one memorable scene, Jimmy Cliff's character Rygin walks into a recording studio as the Maytals are recording. The Harder They Come soundtrack would feature two songs from the Maytals, Sweet and Dandy, which is the song they perform in the movie, and also Pressure Drop, another one of their classic shots, a staple of live performances ever after. Copy on White Island label, The Harder They Come. At this point in Jamaican music was poised for a larger international a breakthrough than it had ever known before. There was something of a vacuum. The breakout star could have been Jimmy Cliff. It could have been Toots and the Maytals. Ended up being Bob Marley and the Wailers. But Toots and the Maytals, now is credited to promote Toots as the lead singer, which he was always the undeniable force, front vocal assault, he was from the start. Just promoting him as the front man to give that front man identification for a larger rock audience. They put out several albums through Trojan Records in the UK. I don't have all of those. I do have In the Dark. You can see Toots front and center, Toots Hibbert, Jerry Mathias, and Raleigh Gordon backing up. Trojan Records, very early 1970s here. This contains songs like Got to Be There, Time Tough, one of his reality songs, talking about social situations, economic situations, Take Me Home, Country Roads, was a sizable hit, which reworked John Denver's classic, just changing the locale from West Virginia to Jamaica. Take Me Home, Country Roads, Fever, Love Gonna Walk Out on Me. Mix of political and more romantic theme songs. The breakthrough album for Toots and the Maytals would be Funky Kingston, which appeared in two versions, an early 1970s version, which was released in the UK and Jamaica, and then the more wider distributed US version. In 1975, the iconic Funky Kingston album from Toots and the Maytals, of course containing the title track, actually bears very little resemblance to the original 1970s release, but is kind of a amalgamation of some of the tracks from In the Dark for the US release of Funky Kingston. And this copy is Island Records, 1975. Funky Kingston, reggae cornerstone of any collection, must have. If you must have one Toots and the Maytals album, it's gotta be this one. Pressure Drop, Pomp and Pride, Funky Kingston, Funky Kingston, the title track, another one of Toots' standards that would be recorded, that would be a standard, a staple of any live performance he appeared on. 1976 brought Reggae Got Soul. Again, making plain Toots Hibbert's connection to American soul music and its grounding in the church. Again, on Island Records. When he was recording for Leslie Kong's Beverly's Records, the backing band, the Beverly's All-Stars, version side there, Beverly's All-Stars. Those backing players would include people like Jackie Jackson on bass, Hux Brown on lead guitar, Rad Brian on rhythm guitar, Winston Wright on organ, and many of those players would play for Toots for many years to come, all the way through the 1970s. They definitely feature on this album here. There they are there. Longtime backing band for Toots and the Maytals, as he continued to release high-profile international albums through the 1970s, which were well-received in the rock world, reviewed in Rolling Stone and other publications. Toots on his way to becoming a high-profile ambassador for Jamaican music internationally, while perhaps losing some ground in the domestic market as Roots took over through the 1970s. In the early 1980s, lineups began to change. Toots put out a live album in 1980, which was a limited release of a session at the Hammersmith Palais, recorded September 29th. This was recorded and pressed to record within 24 hours, something of a record. Still had the original group, Raleigh Gordon and Jerry Mathias, with the backup vocals. They would depart in the early 1980s. Some new players starting to come into the band, like Carl Harvey on guitar. I believe this is his first appearance with the band. He would remain the guitarist for Toots and the Maytals band forever after, right up to the present. I woke up this morning to the news that Toots had passed through Carl Harvey's Facebook post. Toots and the Maytals, live at the Hammersmith Palais. Again, documenting one of their many live performances. While the albums would begin to appear more sporadically from Toots and the Maytals, he definitely had albums like Pass the Pipe, which was actually one of the first kind of reggae albums I ever heard. I remember taking that one out from the Vancouver Public Library many years ago. I don't have a copy of it currently. Knockout, which featured Toots on the cover in a boxing pose. He had been a boxer in the 1960s, also worked as a barber before moving into music. Albums would start to appear more sporadically from Toots and the Maytals, but they would be constantly in demand for live performances over the US, Europe, all over the world, well-received live performances. He was a fantastically energetic live performer. In the mid-1980s, Toots in Memphis would appear, again, making plain his debt to American soul music. Very well-received album, recorded in Memphis, Tennessee. Mango, subsidiary of Island Records. And this has covers of Al Green's Love and Happiness, Eddie Floyd's Knock on Wood, many American soul standards. Toots and the Maytals. In 2005, he would win a Grammy for the True Love album. It's another ex-library copy I picked up. This featured guest appearances from Willie Nelson, Bonnie Raitt, Eric Clapton, Jeff Beck, many others. Many of these international rock stars, fans of Toots Hibbert and his vocal style. What else to say about Toots Hibbert, the great Toots Hibbert? You might be able to see that poster right there on my left. Headliner was Toots Hibbert. The one and only time I got to see him live was 2005, I believe. This was the album out at the time. He was on tour. He did a doubleheader show in Vancouver in Stanley Park, right by the sea. It's a natural amphitheater called Brockton Oval. He performed there a doubleheader concert with several other artists, opening the show, and a doubleheader between Toots and the Maytals and Burning Spear. It was a warm summer night. This amphitheater surrounded by the trees was absolutely rammed with people. I heard later people were jumping the fence to get in because it was sold out. If you wanted to go to the bathroom, the outhouse, forget about it. You'd be in line up for like 20 minutes, half an hour. You could walk a few feet from where you were standing to watch the show and not be able to find your way back because it was absolutely thronged with bodies. Exotic substances being consumed everywhere you looked. There were many logistics challenges, but everyone was there for a fabulous night. Everyone was in a positive frame of mind. It was a magical night, I'll always remember. We were treated to the Afrobeat of Alpha Yaya Diallo and the Roots vibes of Burning Spear, and then Toots and the Maytals closed out the night with Toots in his 60s at that point, dancing across the stage in a way I couldn't have. And I'll always still be able to hear his voice with that that call and response vocal of hey, 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 from Funky Kingston ringing out into the warm night air. Fabulous performance from one of the legends of Jamaican music. He would continue performing, continue recording through the 2000s. In 2013, his career hit a snag when he was hit by a bottle on stage in Virginia, in America. He was injured, suffered from headaches and depression after that, I believe, launched a lawsuit against the promoter. The person who threw the bottle was caught and charged, but Toots actually wrote a letter to the judge, to the court, asking for clemency for the person that had done it. As he said in the letter, he knew what jail was like and he did not want to subject that to another person. But that person did end up being punished. But Toots eventually recovered, continued recording. He actually just put out a brand new album shortly before his illness called Got to Be Tough. Is out right now. I have not had a chance to pick that up yet. But leaves behind a massive legacy of music. One-of-a-kind voice in Jamaican music. You will always recognize his voice when you hear it on record. And we will not see his like again, but the music lives on and will never grow old. So rest in peace, rest in Zion, Frederick Toots Hibbert. Thanks for watching, everybody. Peace.